Thunderdome Boxing Talk, Anthony here. All right, Lomachenko Walters coming up this Saturday after the replay of the Kovalev Ward travesty. Hopefully, this great fight, you know, ends with, you know, a just decision, which I think it will. I pretty much guarantee it will, just because, you know, they're both top-ranked fighters. If anyone was going to be favored, it would be Loma, because of the Pacquiao fight possibly down the road, which Aram has talked about several times, including just yesterday again, I believe. And Walters isn't, you know, an American. He isn't a gold medalist from America. So, you know, I think it'll, you know, the winner will win. Obviously, if it's a decision, if it's a knockout, then, you know, no need for the cards. But, you got Loma, 5'6", 66 inch reach, I think, 65 and a half. You got it. Yeah, 65 and a half. Or 66. I don't know. I just know Walters is 73 and he got a 7-inch reach. So, you know. That'd be what? 66. Now, and a 1-inch height advantage. A lot of people are making a big deal out of that, 7-inch reach advantage, which that, I mean, it is, you know, a huge reach advantage. But, you know, if you remember the Pac Margarito fight, Margo had a 6-inch reach advantage and a 5.5-inch height advantage. So, you know, that's much bigger. Because, you know, when you have that, the, you know, a 6-inch reach plus almost a 6-inch height advantage, that adds a lot more range to you than just a reach advantage. And it didn't affect Pacquiao at all. And why? Because the talent level was huge. You know, the talent gap. Pacquiao was just a much more talented fighter than Margarito was. And the same goes for this fight. Loma is a much more talented fighter than Walters. Now, and also, Margarito, you know, pound for pound, was a much, much better fighter than Walters. Alright? And with Lomachenko and Pacquiao, you know, Pacquiao is the definition of pound for pound because he climbs so many weight classes. So I would say he's, as of now, he was the better pound for pound fighter. We'll have to see what happens with Loma, but I don't think he'll do what Pacquiao did by no means. But the gap of, you know, the talent gap in the Pacquiao Margarito fight, I don't think was as big as the gap in talent in this fight. Wasn't as big, just because, put it this way, would Floyd Mayweather have shamelessly ducked Walters at even 140 or 147? No, he wouldn't have. He would have beat Walters' ass, and he shamelessly ducked Margarito. Margarito is a monster. Walters isn't a monster, man. He's just a good fighter. You know, he's a very good fighter, but he's not a monster like Margarito was. That was Pacquiao's toughest fight ever, you know. He took more punishment in that fight than any fight ever, you know. And I'm talking punishment. Obviously, Marquez knocked him out in the fourth fight, but he didn't take nowhere near the amount of punishment. So, you know, just because you have this big reach advantage doesn't mean you're even likely to win. I mean, it's why, you know, Loma's a huge favorite for a reason. Because not many people think he is going to lose to Nicholas Walters. That doesn't mean Walters can't win. There's a couple, you know, game plans, I think that he could, you know, make work to his advantage and win. I don't think it'll happen, but it could. And I'll get into that. But Lomachenko being a southpaw is going to add another wrinkle to this. You know, the straight right is the best weapon for a southpaw. And that's, you know, that of the left hook is Walter's best punch. I think his best punch is the straight right. So that's going to cause some troubles for Lomachenko. And I think the first few rounds will probably be the toughest rounds for Loma, and then he'll, once his motor starts going like it normally does, he'll really start to take over. And I think he'll win a decision. I wouldn't be surprised though if he stopped them, honestly. And I'll get to that actually, but the speed and quickness, you know, the mental quickness and the just physical speed, hand, foot, upper body, just all-around quickness and all-around speed. I mean, all-around speed and the quickness of Loma is just like uber superior to Walters. And that's going to be the biggest factor in this fight. I've always said that, man, you know, when two guys are generally pound for pound, you know, equal in skill set, whether they have different styles, but, you know, they kind of even out, you know, through, you know, just generally even, but different styles or whatever, always go with the guy that's has the more speed, because 8-9 times out of 10, he's going to win. Speed kills in boxing. And it's going to be really hard for Walters to overcome that speed. And being that he doesn't have superior timing either, you know, because timing will offset speed, but Loma has better timing as well. So this is going to be a lot for Walters to overcome. I mean, that's the reason he didn't want the fight in the first place. And you could be like, well, he took it. What are you saying he didn't want it? If he thought he could beat Walters, or if Walters thought he could beat Loma, he should have took it before, because he would have made way more money. Especially if he won, he was getting $300,000 extra. You know, and he was even quoted at that point in time saying, I'm not going to take this fight because I can't beat him unless I land a knockout punch. And he wasn't saying I'll get robbed. He was just saying, I know I can't outbox this guy. So, yeah, he's going to have to land a knockout punch, or there's a couple ways I think he may be able to, a couple game plans that he could use to maybe beat Loma. And the speed and what, you know, the upper body movement that, from the waist, you know, and with the footwork and the angles of Loma, it's going to be really hard, because that dude's perpetual motion, man, and he don't just move to just keep moving. He's moving at rapid fire speed. I mean, look at how hard it was for someone with, like, quite possibly pound for pound the fastest hands in boxing, Gary Russell Jr., to land anything on him, anything significant. Basically, everything he really landed on him, like, that he landed, it was blocked, you know? So, it's really going to be hard for Walters, who doesn't even punch half as fast as Gary Russell Jr., you know what I mean? Those angles, you know, and Walters is going to be getting turned all night long, you know? Obviously, that right hand is going to be Walters' money punch, because that's the money punch for a southpaw. So he's going to stick right on Walters' left side and keep turning Walters. You know, Loma is going to keep going to his left and avoiding that right hand. I mean, I'm sorry. My bad. He's going to keep going to his right. Loma's going to keep going to his right and turning Walters. That way it's hard, you know, because every time he goes to throw, he's going to you know, be trying to turn, and he has to set his feet to punch. He can't punch on the move. Loma can. Loma can rapid fire pop the jab while moving around, you know, dancing on his feet. He can throw combos while moving his feet. He can plant his feet and rip a combo and then hurry up and turn you so fast, fire another combo off that you didn't even, you know, you just had your feet set defending yourself. And then the moment he stops punching and you go to let something go and dare to drop your hands, you're getting cracked again. You know, and he sets the most advanced traps in boxing, in my opinion. You know, like, look at what he did to Rocky Martinez. I mean, that was freaking beautiful. Beautiful. And he's quite possibly the best defensive fighter in all of boxing. So, to land that big knockout punch for Walters, you know, just that alone, the speed, the quickness, the angles, the footwork, the timing, the, you know, the upper body movement, that alone is going to make it so hard to land that big knockout punch. You know, I don't like saying the term lucky punch, because very, very rarely is a punch lucky. You know, there's a few examples I could think of where a guy actually landed a lucky punch, like eyes closed and just wung something, and it landed, you know, and really hurt a guy or knocked him out. But, you know, that's lucky. But, you know, I don't like saying lucky punch, so I don't think he could get lucky and land something. But I think if he landed something, it would probably be because he set something up. I just think it'll be really, really hard. And I don't know, you know, Loma has solid power himself, and his power carries late into fights. You know, look at the Salido fight. Even after getting hit in the junk, God knows how many times, you know, 20 times, 20 low blows, and the guy still had stamina out the ass and was able to come on so strong at the end, he almost knocked Salido out. You know, it should have been Salido coming on strong at the end. But it wasn't, because Lomachenko's stamina is out of this world. The guy trains constantly, and he does, like, some of the most unorthodox training that boxers just don't do. Like, he does, you know, Bruce Lee used to have that thing in his house. I don't know if you guys heard, you know, watched his documentaries or whatever, but he had, like, a wall set up with little holes in it, and there was little light bulbs behind, like, a little thin, like, little piece of paper or whatever, and he'd stand like 3 feet away. He'd stand 3 feet away, and one of the holes would blink, and he had a second to hurry up and bow, poke a finger into that hole. Well, Loma does the same thing, and he doesn't just do it like once, like Bruce Lee. Like, Bruce Lee would just be like, bow, got it. Loma does it with, you know, light, 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 and he keeps hitting them, boom, 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 boom. I mean, he does all kinds of crazy shit, and that's why his, you know, accuracy and timing is amazing. You know, you leave an opening for 1 second, and he's gonna put something on you. And he got solid power. You know, we don't know how good his power is gonna be at 130, if it has increased, because, you know, he did knock Rocky Martinez in the next week, but you know, that doesn't mean that's, you know, gonna happen in, you know, the majority of his fights or anything. That's not a sure sign that, you know, his power had gotten better when he moved up. It may be, though. We'll find out probably in this fight, you know. And he's gonna be putting a lot of body work in on Walters also, because he does to everybody, you know. Combination puncher. Loma is, again, you know, one of the best combination punchers. He reminds me of a young Manny Pacquiao, but he throws, you know, better combos. You know, Manny would, you know, throw a lot of, I don't want to say better, but he has more variety in his combinations. You know, like, he'll throw the, you know, straight punches, hooks, uppercuts, body shots up top, then, you know, come back to the body and go back up top. He throws 6, 7, 8 punch combos just as well, like Manny Pacquiao did. You know, so that pace alone and the pace of him, never, he doesn't, like, take rounds off. He doesn't take breaks during rounds. And Walters isn't a fast-paced fighter, by no means. By no means. If anything, he's average-paced or slightly below average pace when he's pushing the pace. And if, you know, first of all, I don't think Loma's going to allow him to push the pace. I don't think he'll be able to. Period. I know he's not going to be able to, actually. And I'm curious to see if Walters is going to be able to keep up with Loma's pace. Like, I think if Loma stopped him, it would come late in the fight because Walters may gas. I don't see him necessarily just landing a vicious shot like he did on Rocky Martinez in, say, like the 4th, 5th, 6th round. I think if he did stop him, it'll come late in the fight. But I do have him winning, you know, by decision, not stoppage. But I wouldn't be surprised. Wouldn't be surprised. And, you know, Loma is just, every fight he's getting better, because he's getting more professional experience. And, you know, he's even talked about this, how every fight he's getting better because of the experience, you know, and he's going to keep getting better, which is scary, which is really scary. He's also an all-around better athlete than Walters is. You know, Walters is a fairly limited fighter. Fairly limited. I'll get to what I like about Walters, too, and I think his strong suits are in this fight, too. I'm just doing Loma right now, so don't think I'm shitting on Walters. I'm just doing Loma, and I'll get to Walters. But Loma is the superior athlete. He can do way more. He's a athletic freak, man. He's a once-in-a-lifetime fighter, too. He's a once-in-boxing-history fighter. What the hell am I talking about? You have never seen a fighter even close to Loma. Not even Roy Jones. Roy was also a once-in-boxing-history fighter, but they weren't alike. You know, does Loma like to copy some of his stuff because that was one of his, you know, childhood idols? Yeah. But he fights completely different. You know, Roy didn't fight in the high guard, bending all at the waist, staying right in the pocket and turning you and lighting you up with combos. No, he liked to stay at mid-range and really pot shot you. And, you know, every now and then he'd rip combos too, obviously. Like, it was 3 left hooks in a row, like, bow, 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 and then go rip one to the body. But he wasn't a stay right in the pocket and let combos rip with both hands. You know, up top, down low, come back up top. That wasn't him. You know, just wasn't. Because he didn't need to do that, really. He was just too fast where he could just keep smacking you until he either won by this wide decision or knocked you the hell out. Because he had one of the best left hooks to the liver in the business. So, you know, he would really look for them big one-punch knockout shots, them spectacular knockouts. Loma's more of an accumulation fighter. And maybe going up in weight, that will change. Who knows? It's too early to tell. It's just too early to tell. The head movement. That also goes along with the upper body movement. Now, obviously, you throw a punch, he can slip it, just without his, you know, upper body movement, just a quick boom. But he also got the upper body movement where he can boom, slip, and then bang, come right back. Walters doesn't have very good upper body movement or head movement. We've seen him look damn good in some fights, but there were fights where he was a fucking size bully. Now, he's going to be a size bully in this fight, too, but guys like Mariaga, Jason Sosa, who I thought he beat clearly, Donaire and Darchinian. I mean, he was much bigger than every one of those guys. And none of them were even close to the level of Lomachenko. Not even close, man. I mean, 126-pound Donaire was nothing. Man, it was a... I mean, he really wasn't even a top 10 featherweight, honestly. Mariaga, same thing. Nothing special at all. Darchinian, give me a break, you know. Jason Sosa, most definitely a top 10, 126-pounder. 130-pounder. Most definitely a top 10, 130-pounder champion now, you know. But they went at it really good. They had a really tough fight. And I think Loma would destroy Sosa, but I do think that Walters won that fight clearly. I think Loma would have won it much more clearly, but, you know, maybe Walters could have done better had he not stayed in the pocket, but maybe that was also because Sosa made him stay there, you know, was keeping him there, you know, but they were just chewing each other's bodies up, so maybe that, you know, took a little bit of both out of their legs. Who knows? I would like to see a rematch. Even if, you know, I'd like to see the winner fight Sosa, first of all, but I still would like to see a rematch between Walters and Sosa, because Sosa's also gotten better, picked up some good wins since then, and I think Walters deserves a rematch. You know, he won that fight and only got a draw. He won it, in my opinion. I think the majority of people think he won it. And I think he deserves a rematch to, you know, get his revenge. I think they should have had an immediate rematch. And that's another thing. Walters hasn't fought since the Sosa fight. That's 11 months ago, man. It'll be, 11, you know, it's almost a year, really. Because when was that? That wasn't even this year. They fought last year, December, like, middle of December last year. It's like 11 months. Loma just fought 5 months ago, you know, and looked spectacular. And he's really been in the gym nonstop since. I was just watching some training footage of both of them, and Loma looked so much sharper. And why? Activity. Why did I tell you Kovalev was a big reason Kovalev was going to beat Ward? Which he did, so just shut up about that. Activity, sharpness, and that was proven. I mean, shout out Precise, that film study you just did was phenomenal. And it showed without a shadow of a doubt that any of these people saying Ward won he's either their favorite fighter, and they're biased. They do not know how to score a professional boxing match. They're biased for whatever reason. Maybe it's nationalistic pride. Maybe it's racial bias. Maybe, you know, they're from, you know, Cali or, you know, the Bay Area, and they have, you know, hometown bias. Whatever. Or that, you know, they're incompetent and don't know how to score a professional fight. But go watch Precise's film study, and he doesn't talk shit. He's not, so you're not gonna get angry watching it. You're just gonna watch a brilliant film study. And then I dare you to say that Ward won that fucking fight. And if you didn't see it, by the way, Ward kneed Kovalev right in his fucking face. After Ward hurt him and he went on the run, and then when Ward got cornered, he tackled Kovalev, and Ward went to the ground, and when he went to step over him, he slammed his knee right into Kovalev's face. That's why he got up and his nose was all bloody after that. Now, it had been bloody earlier, but it had been cleaned up and hadn't bled for like 2-3 rounds or something, and as soon as he stood up from getting kneed in the face, his nose was bloody as hell. He didn't put that in that film study. But I left comment in that film study, or if you don't believe me, I give you the timestamp and everything. You can't see it on the HBO telecast because they didn't show they didn't show low enough. You have to watch the Inside the Arena video where someone was filming it from inside the arena, and he blasted him with a knee right in his face. I mean, that guy is so dirty, man. So dirty. He's the dirtiest fighter in all of boxing. Ridiculous. What the hell was I talking about? Shit. Sharpness. Yeah, I was talking about the activity. And I was saying how, you know, Ward had fought, you know, three guys in 4 years and four guys in 5 years. With, you know, once 2012, once 2013, didn't fight in 2014, once in 2015, and fought two scrubs in 2015. That is not getting you ready for an A-level fighter, and it just can't. It can't. Now, Walters ain't going to be that, you know. He'll be sharper than Ward, but he ain't going to be as sharp as Loma. He's just not, you know. He also doesn't train year-round. He blows up in weight in between fights. Loma does not. Loma could take fights on short notice anytime. He's always training. So that's going to play a huge part, too. And, you know, that's also going to affect the timing of both men. It's going to affect the quickness of both men, the defense of both men, the accuracy of both men, and it's all of those are going to favor Lomachenko due to activity. You know, it is what it is. You can't take a year off and expect to come back like nothing happened, especially fighting the best fighter you have ever fought by far. No. It just don't happen. It just don't happen. And it ain't gonna happen this time either. No way in hell. But accuracy also. Just the accuracy. Walters isn't, he's accurate. He's an accurate puncher. Nowhere near as accurate as Lomachenko, though. He's very accurate. Extremely accurate. One of the top three, four most accurate fighters in all of boxing. Walters, not even in the top 10. You know? And, like I said, that's not hating. That's facts. Discipline and focus. You know? I don't know if Loma starts to get beaten, you know, he starts to lose rounds, you know, several rounds, say he loses 3-4 rounds in a row, his focus won't break. His discipline won't falter. He'll just stick with what he's doing, or, you know, adjust and keep going right at it, knowing I'm going to win this fight. Whether he is or not, he'll still think I'm winning this fight, even if I just lost the last four rounds. I don't know if I can say the same thing about Walters, because I've never seen him in that position. I have seen Loma in that position in only his second pro fight, and his focus and discipline didn't falter at all. You know, he still kept up and just kept going, saying, I know I'll win this. And he almost did. He almost knocked Salido out. Was really close to doing it. controlling range. Loma's definitely better at controlling range. Now, if Walters can work that jab properly, and even the 1-2 properly, and uses legs, it might make it hard for Loma to be able to control the range. That might, you know, allow Walters to control the range, and then Loma's going to be in trouble. Then he'll have to make some serious adjustments and find a way to get inside to where he can now control the range. But I think he's going to be able to get under that, you know, a fighter with a huge long reach. This is just all anyone who box knows this, man. When a guy has a big long reach over you and you're much faster, like Mike Tyson, for example, did it all the time. Fought guys taller and with much longer reaches. I'm talking much longer than 7 inches. And what happened? He got inside every fucking time. You know, I'm talking prime Tyson, not like when he fought Lewis or something like that. But prime Tyson, didn't matter how athletic you were, how good of a fighter you were. And a lot of those guys were very good. You know, they'd be top heavyweights right now, you know? But what was it? His head movement, getting down low, everything, you know, the waist movement, the shifting, the angles, everything Loma does. And why could he do that? Because his timing, his speed, he could see that punch coming a mile away. Because it takes a long time for those long punches to get there. And Loma's going to see him, that jab coming from a mile away. It's going to take forever in his eyes to get there. Same with the two. So when that jab comes, he's going to be able to crouch down, whoop, slip right under it, get right inside. But Walters can fight on the inside too, even with those long arms. It's rare you got fighters with very long arms that can fight very well on the inside. And Walters can. So that'll make it interesting. But he can't, he doesn't have the foot speed or the ability of, turning a fighter and hitting angles, like Loma, or really at all, honestly. He's a pretty much go straight forward, straight back, or stand right there. You know, he can pivot, but he can't, you know, he ain't even one of the top 20 fighters when it comes to, you know, hitting angles. And, you know, so that's obviously going to, I think that's going to be the key to Loma. He's going to really get inside, work him over, hurry up and keep turning him. That way Walters can't get set and start to infight with him. I think Walters is going to need to do that to win. And he might be able to. We'll have to find out. I think that's going to be one of his game plans, that which I'll get to. But is Lomachenko the smartest fighter in boxing? I mean, and I'm being dead serious. He very well might be. Like, he might be the smartest fighter in boxing. There's a couple other candidates out there, but he is definitely in the top three. You know what I mean? Again, Walters ain't even in the top 20, man. I can definitely name you 20 fighters that have a higher ring IQ than Walters. So this is all a lot for Walters to go up against. And that's why he didn't want to fight in the first place. Because he knows this. He's not a dumb fighter. He knows boxing, but he just knows what his limits are and his capabilities. And he knows Loma's capabilities, you know, that just is what it is, too. I talked about the stamina of Loma and how, you know, that just the perpetual motion. I am really curious to see if. And being out of the ring for 11 months, that's going to affect his stamina also, because he was not training for those 11 months, man. He wasn't. I saw pictures of him. He was not in good shape. He wasn't fat, you know, and ballooned up to, you know, 170 pounds or something, but he wasn't, you know, training either. So, you know, his stamina is going to be just what it always was, you know. He can't just go into this camp and push himself so hard to where his stamina is going to be better than it ever was, because he'll be overtrained. You know, he could work more on cardio, I guess, but I think he has more pressing things to work on, like dealing with a guy that fast and hitting angles and, well, what I'll get to, in his game plans anyway. Yeah, but anyway, let's talk about Walters now. The Darchinian win, obviously one of his four best wins, you know, and Loma's four best wins would be what? Four best fights. Four best fighters he fought, actually. Let's just say that, because he lost to Salido, even though that wasn't a, you know, real, real loss. I mean, come on. I mean, that's why Salido don't even want that work at this moment. Priced himself out of the rematch. But Tadakun, Salido, Gary Russell Jr., and Roman Martinez. Three of which he destroyed and embarrassed, and one cheated like all hell and barely won. And won't give him a fucking rematch either, which I find disgraceful, especially when you won in such a disgraceful manner. Man up. And Salido's a warrior, man. Like, I'm not a big fan of Salido because he's such a dirty fighter, and I just don't respect that at all. Like, I you know, fighting a little dirty, okay, but when your whole fucking game plan revolves around it in every single fight, then I'm not a fan of you. I'm a fan of his warrior spirit, but, you know, it really let me down when he didn't want to give Loma his rematch either. That was kind of bullshit, you know, considering he won in such a disgraceful manner. Like, he's acting like, no, I hold all the cards because I beat you the first time. Like, no, you really don't hold any of the cards, buddy. Loma's going to be your biggest payday, first of all. And you, no one looks at you like you beat him, you know, because you didn't really beat him. You got the W, but you didn't really beat him, you know. It's like, Ward and Jizzle Kovalev, you know what I mean? He also has to give an immediate rematch, or he's going to be looked at as the biggest pussy in boxing. It's that simple. And he kind of already is looked at like that with how he talked about it, talked about Kovalev after the fight. Couldn't even give the guy any fucking credit. You know, none. And did not want to talk about the rematch, even though it's in the contract. I'd be willing to bet that if Roc Nation doesn't need to recoup more money from, or doesn't want to recoup more money ASAP from our Ward, because they know that any of these light heavyweights can beat him. He is not built for the light heavyweight division. He's too weak for that division. I mean, like, weak, like, strength-wise. All them light heavyweights are stronger than him. Too many of the light heavyweight division is freaking stacked. And the WBA got Nathan Cleverly as his Mando. So I'm expecting him to weasel his way out and make Kathy Duva fucking sue. And he's going to fight Nathan Cleverly in Oakland in the meantime, because Cleverly don't hit that hard. So, you know, he can just do his normal little fight like a dirty-ass bitch, and they'll, you know, give him the decision. You know, or they'll stop it on cuts because he's going to headbutt the shit out of Cleverly, too. But I think that's probably his next opponent, Cleverly in Oakland. Unless HBO and Roc Nation really get on his ass. But his contract with HBO's up. He is going to re-sign with them, because they're going to throw a shit ton of money at him, even if they only re-sign him, you know, sign him up for one more fight or whatever. But they'll sign him up for, you know, maybe another 3-fight deal or something. At least 2, because they're probably looking at a trilogy now with Kovalev. But I don't think he wants that rematch anytime soon, because he knows Kovalev beat him, and I don't think he's going to want to get beat, you know, in his very next fight. I think he's going to want to make a couple more bucks before the rematch. Now, there is an immediate rematch clause in the contract, but that don't mean he has to honor it. I mean, we know Ward don't honor contracts he already signed and agreed to everything on. You know, and people held up their end. He still sues you multiple times. So he has no problem going back to court. And I think he's going to do that, you know. Unless Roc Nation is like, no, you're fucking fighting this guy immediately because we still need to make more money off of you. And this is the biggest money fight out there. Even though I don't think many people will buy the rematch. Just because they felt they got so jobbed on the first one that they're like, you fucking owe us a legit fight still. At least that's how I feel. And a lot of people I talked to said they are not buying the rematch. They'll stream it because they want to watch it, but they're not buying it. And that's basically everyone I talked to. But Walters, best four opponents, Darchinian. You know, come on, garbage win. Donaire, you know, like I said, not even a top 10, top 15, 126 pounder. Mariaga, same thing. Sosa was his best opponent ever. And he beat him. He beat him. Top 10, current world champion at 130, and he beat him. I thought he beat him convincingly, too. That's definitely his best win, and it's over a very legit opponent. If he hadn't beaten Sosa, I'd look at this fight as a fucking whitewash. But, you know, at least Sosa, he proved he could beat a top-level 130-pounder. Sosa ain't no Lomachenko, but still, it makes the fight a lot more intriguing to me personally. Now, Walters, like Kovalev, has a long rangey jab. A long rangey jab. Not a power jab like Kovalev's, but a long rangey jab. It's not accurate like Kovalev's either, but it is a long rangey jab. It's not very fast. But, again, it's just long and rangy, but nothing else really to it. It's just long and rangy. It's not a power jab, you know, not fast. It's not very accurate. And he can't pop the jab on the move, which he really is going to need to do versus Loma. So, hopefully, they've been working on that in camp. Because that's a key to one of the game plans, I think, that he may be able to beat Loma with, which I'll get to them in a minute. The two game plans I think he could employ to lead himself to victory. He actually, not only can he not jab on the move, he can't punch on the move, period, actually. Like, he can jab and then take a step in with a right hand or something, but he can't, you know, like Lomachenko can punch on a move, Pacquiao can punch on a move, Bradley, you know, Floyd, Kovalev, all these guys can, you know, pop, pop, pop while, you know, moving, you know, circling their opponent, bang, 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 like Muhammad Ali type things, but not, you know, exactly like Muhammad Ali, but, you know, punch on the move. He has to have his feet planted for all of his punches. That spells disaster when you're facing Lomachenko. It really does. He is a very good body puncher, Walters is. Walters can tear up your body. And I think he's going to need to rip into to Loma's body every chance he gets. I hate saying this because I hate dirty fighters, but, you know, even hitting him on the hips, you know, a couple low blows, didn't really help Salido any, though, but, you know, might help him. Who knows? You know, I don't know. I don't want to see him do it, but I'm just saying what he might do. You know, I'm not saying I think he should, but, you know, his team is probably going to have him, you know, throwing some borderline low blows, if not flat out low blows, trying to really, you know, take Loma's legs out from under him, you know, to make him more of a stationary target to then chew up his body, rip them uppercuts he got, you know, because he got a vicious right uppercut. And, you know, Loma likes to duck down and swoop under. You know, if he could rip his body and then, you know, pivot while Loma's trying to turn him, rack that uppercut, left hook, boom. Kind of like what Loma did to Rocky Martinez. You know, if he could do that, he might be able to knock Walters out or knock Loma out right then and there. You never know. But this will also, because he's going to eat some clean shots, obviously, a lot of clean shots from Walters. He'll probably eat Walters' best punch, too. Maybe only like once or twice, his, you know, a real hard right hand. But it's going to be interesting to see how Loma handles that. That'll let us know where, if he has a world-class chin or not. We definitely know he has a good chin. Just we don't know how good. And this could let us know. This fight probably will let us know. Walters isn't really a good combination puncher. He can throw, and when I say combination puncher, I'm talking like bop, 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 rap, rap, whap, 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 whap. You know, no, he'll throw like, he'll rip one to the body, rip one up top, rip one down low, rip back up top, rip low, rip up top. But they're all really one at a time, just in succession, to where it's, you know, he's throwing, you know, four punches in a row, but it's not a combo. You know, he's not going like, boom, and then using all that leverage into the next one, that leverage into the next one, that leverage into the next one. Each one is really, it's boom, boom, one at a time. And he might be able to put them together semi-fast, you know, for him, but they're not combinations, you know. They're one punch at a time, but in succession. You know, that's not a combination. That's just, you know, throwing four punches in a row, but just four single punches in a row. Loma, we already talked about that. He can throw four, five, six, seven, eight punches in a combination, not in succession, combination, using the leverage off of that last shot to put into his next shot. Walters don't do that. And that's going to be a problem, too, because to really put something on Loma, you need to throw more than one at a time, you know? And I'm not talking, like, you know, two, three in succession. I'm talking two, three, like, whoa, whoa, whoa. Because even Gary Russell was throwing four, five-punch combos fast as lightning. Loma was slipping and blocking them all, you know? Not every damn fucking punch, but you know, you get the picture, you know. He'd block a four, five, six punch combo, and it, or slip or block every one of them. So if, I see it being really hard for Walters to land anything meaningful when Gary Russell couldn't. I mean, you know, and come on, man, Gary Russell got the fastest hands from Amir Khan on down, and pound for pound his hands might be even faster than Amir Khan's, you know, because Amir throws them really fast, you know, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, but Gary Russell can throw every punch very fast and very fast combos, you know, like round the clock punches, not just the straight down the pipe ones like Khan can rapid fire out there. So it's really going to be tough for Walters to land these big shots. People are picking him to beat Loma by landing. You know, some people, you know, I don't know, man. I honestly think if he does and you pick that as the outcome, don't say I told you so, because, I mean, you could say you told you so, but admit you really didn't know what the fuck you were saying. You got lucky, and it just happened to turn out the way you wanted it to. It's what it is, because I don't think half, I don't think 90% of you believe half the shit you're saying when you're talking about what Walters is going to do. I just think you want that to happen. And that's not how you're supposed to pick fights. You pick fights with your brain, and you analyze them with your brain, not your heart. Okay? Too many people in this YouTube boxing community analyze, or so-called analyze, but pick with their heart and not their brain. Let's wrap this up real quick. What else can I talk about? I was talking about the Walters being a very good body puncher, as we saw in the Sosa fight. My God, that was like, I loved that about that fight, how I loved the catching and shooting that Walters was doing, and how he was ripping to Sosa's body. Sosa was also doing it back, but Sosa ain't in this fight, you know, so it's about Walters. But I thought Walters also still did the better body, had the much better body work. And I thought he was blocking a lot of Sosa's punches. And Sosa wasn't blocking nearly as many of Walters. And you know, that's why I thought he won. But he needs to really, really work Loma's body, man. Really work it. Just to slow him down, you know. Just so Loma isn't going, you know, full steam ahead in that, you know, 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th round. Because if he can slow him down, he has a really good chance of then being able to get him out of there in the later rounds. If he doesn't, and Loma gets into his groove like he gets into, it's over, man. It's fucking over. Because once he gets your timing down and he's in his groove, it's a wrap. It's a wrap. If you see him get into that groove, fight's over. Fight's over, I'm telling you. Unless he makes some ridiculous mistake, but 95% chance that fight's over if he gets into his groove. And Walters has to do everything in his power to not let Walters has to do everything in his power to not let Loma get into his groove, to not let him start burning, and to not let him, you know, really get that engine going. Because once it starts going, it don't stop. The fight's just his now, and you know, no one outside of maybe Vargas can fight at that pace, you know, and I think he would even break Vargas down. I think he would even beat Vargas, and Vargas is like my favorite fighter at 130. Hey man, Loma, that's the fight I really want to see at 130. But I think Loma would still get him, but you know, Vargas can just dig so deep that he'll just keep going. I mean, look at the Vargas-Salido fight, and, you know, come on, man. He was going all 12 rounds, just burning. Not at the pace of a Lomachenko, but at a high pace, at a fast pace, real fast pace. Did I talk about activity? Yeah, I did. I was talking about the 11 months off. Again, that activity is going to really affect Walter's sharpness. I mean, the sharper fighter also wins more times than, you know, 8 times out of 10, especially if he's the faster fighter. You know, and the guys are, you know, generally either equally matched or one's better. And in this case, Loma is the more talented fighter, and he's going to be sharper, more active, faster, you know, quicker, you know, better footwork, better angles, all that. I mean, that's why I just don't think Walters can win this fight, man, without, you know, one of these two game plans right here, which I'll get into, actually. Walters has, besides landing a, you know, losing the fight and, you know, Loma making a mistake and then Walters really clipping him with a right hand, left hook, or one of them vicious right uppercuts or a liver shot, you know, a knockout shot, or hurting him and then finishing him, you know, besides that, I think there's two game plans that he could, you know, use to try and win. And I think he should, quite frankly, try them both. Now, don't try, you know, if one's working, stick with it, obviously. But if one isn't, then change it up and go with the other one. And the two game plans are basically, you know, for Walters to win. You know, the two ways I think he has the best chances of winning are, you know, like I said, outside of a puncher's chance, are to go forward, take the fight to Loma, go right at him, you know, and this is also what I don't like, but like I'm saying, I don't like dirty fighters, but I'm sure his team will come, you know, have dirty tactics in their arsenal because they're kind of going to need them. But to go at him, and if he's starting to turn you, like to turn Walters, tie him up. You know, tie him up, and I'm not talking tie him up and hold him. Do like Ward or something like that. Tie him up, get dirty, but better than Ward. Because Ward really, even when he tied Cove up, didn't do shit, you know. He really needs to tie him up, you know, hold him there, try to keep him. If he tries to get away, you know, try to step over to whatever side he's going. Really rip to the body, rip the uppercuts, and keep, like, pushing him back, you know. Don't let him turn you or push you back, you know. Really keep roughing him up, pushing him back, you know. Even if you gotta really, like, get down in with your shoulder and push for, which you're not allowed to do, really, but, you know, still do, you know, I think he'll be doing it if he can. Push him, pop, pop, you know, send him two straight down the pipe, maybe one lands, you know, because once you push him, now he's gonna be off balance, and once you're off balance, you can't use that upper body movement. You might be able to, you know, put a hand up and block it, but, you know, maybe the jab can pierce through in a real hard straight or a loop around the guard, you know, high guard loop, you know, around it and wrap something around that guard, big right hook, left hook, but basically push him forward, go at him, attack him, be rough. You know, attack him, try to wear him down, wear the body down, hit his hips, and just basically roughhouse him. You know, push him back, go forward, march forward nonstop, roughhouse him. that might work. Might work. I don't know if it will. I don't think it will, to be honest. I still just think Loma's too fast for that to work, and that's why the second game plan that I think he'll employ is probably the better of the two and the more likely to lead him to victory, and that's using his legs, using every inch of that ring, staying away from Loma as much as, don't let Loma get into your range. You know, if he starts coming close, back the fuck up and keep popping that jab out, popping that jab out, popping that jab out, and try to get Loma to run into something. You know, pop it, pop it, keep backing up, keep backing up. Try to make him desperate, you know, even if it takes till later on in the fight, you know, because maybe you get some rounds up, maybe his focus breaks and he gets desperate and wants to, you know, get payback and tries to reach in with a big hard shot. Counter him. Walters needs to try to run Loma into something. You know, whether it's a big right uppercut he likes, a straight right, a left hook, a right hook. Just try to run him into something. But, you know, never let Walter should never let Loma near him. Because once Loma's inside, it's a wrap. He ain't going to win. He ain't going to win on the inside. Because Walters needs you right in front of him to fight you, like how he fought Sosa. He needs you to be right in front of him. Loma will not be right in front of him. He'll be turning him. He'll be turning him the whole time. And he'll be turning him, you know, in the opposite way. He ain't going to be going towards that right hand. He's going to be going towards the left and ducking under that left hook, coming over the top of it, going under that left hook, coming up with a jab, coming over top of it. You know, the left hook is only going to be, you know, successful in check left hook fashion, you know, if he's backing up and Loma comes in, bang. You know, if he's popping that jab, and Loma's trying to find a way inside, you know, try to blind him with it, keep popping it, and then throw that shit straight behind, you know, even like line him up with it, you know, and then tap, 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 kind of like Klitschko, you know, blind him with that glove, and then send a shot right behind it, you know, and just move it right at that last second to where he just sees it right before it hits him. That's really the only ways I see him winning. He's either going to have to make it, you know, a rough and tumble just dogfight, or keep the hell away from Loma and keep Loma away from him and at the end of his punches. And anytime Loma gets near him, don't be brave, and because being brave in this way is just being stupid for Walters. Don't be like, oh, you want to fight on the inside? Let's go. Because Walters is going to get chewed up on the inside. So he needs to really keep backing up. Keep backing up, sidestep, you know, lateral movement, boom, 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 you know, even pop a jab, take a fast step to your left laterally, you know, boom, boom, bam, send it right down the pipe, you know, because even if Loma then goes, whoop, he's still getting cracked with it, you know, and, you know, obviously, you know, Loma likes to, so, boom, boom, and then dip under. So, you know, try to time that. You know, try to time it. You know, purposely jab, but then throw your right hand over here. Because he's going to slip the jab. He's going to slip it over here. But really just use it as a decoy jab. Just a real fast one, but not no power behind it. Just fast so you can bring it back fast. And wham! You know, that way when he leans, boom! He runs right into that right hand. That could get him. That could get him. It's going to be a tough, tough task for Walters, though. I do applaud him for finally taking this fight, though, and giving us the fight we wanted for, what, a year and a half now? I think it's been a year and a half. Maybe 2 years now, actually? No, it's been about a year and a half since this fight was first talked about, right? Yeah, right after you beat Donaire. That's when, so yeah, it was about 2 years ago. Finally, we're getting it after 2 years. I'm looking, you know, I was looking forward to the Kovalev Ward fight more. And too bad that turned out the way it did, and, you know. All I've been seeing in Facebook groups and YouTube comments is I'm done with boxing, and of course people will say that and they always come back, but you know, and hopefully this is the fight to bring them back, man. You know, like I saw Montero say, after all the talk of this fight, a lot of people that didn't order it, this is going to be their first chance to watch it. So they'll watch this, and they'll get to watch the Lomachenko-Walters fight right afterwards. And hopefully that can bring some people, you know, back to boxing, or just new fans into boxing. Because any new fans that watch that cohort fight, they're not going to want to watch boxing again for a long time, if ever, man. Like, boxing just loves shooting itself in its foot, man. They always... Every fucking promoter and network is just in it for short-term money. They never fucking look at the big picture and the long haul for the sport of boxing. You know, like, who cares if fans run away now? We want to make all this money tonight. Well, dude, in the long haul, you can make so much more. You know, it's ridiculous. It's ridiculous, man. Like, it just reminds me of, Haplotype. Shout out Haplotype, by the way. His, video, Nash's governing body of, economics, you know. It's sad. It's sad when stuff like that happens in boxing. I hate when the sport I love just gives itself black eyes. You know what I mean? Like, I can understand if a fighter just runs around stinking the joint out, but, you know, he doesn't get the decision, then, oh, well, that's his fault and his value went down. You know, the other fighter can't be blamed for that. But when the one fighter dominates you in every way, and, you know, on the inside, on the outside, hurts you numerous times, it is physically impossible to give Ward even five rounds. And the three belt unified champion gets robbed like that, you know, that's not nowhere near the same. That turns everyone away from boxing. Or not turns everyone, doesn't turn everyone away, but it makes them wonder, why do I keep watching this sport? Why? Why should I even... I saw people talking about how they just canceled their HBO subscription because of it. You know? I can't blame them. You know, I really can't. I ain't, but it's still, it's like, you know, I just hope that this fight lives up to its hype, and the Kovalev Ward fight lives up to its hype. I mean, it went exactly as I thought it would, and I was really looking forward to it, even though I was damn sure how it was going to happen. I didn't think the robbery, though, but I thought the fight itself was lived up to its hype and was what I expected, and I still was happy with the fight, just not the decision. I just hope this one is a very exciting fight and a just decision if it goes to the cards. Whoever wins, whoever that may be, deserves to the decision, and they better fucking get it. A knockout for either guy would always be greater than it going to the cards, though. That way we just don't even have to worry about another robbery. But I don't think it'll be a robbery, since it's two of the same fighters from the same promotional outfit. And, you know, I don't think they're going to have to, you know, rob Loma if it goes to the cards, which is who Aaron would favor to win, because if it goes to the cards, he got it in a bag. And if he gets knocked out, You can't rob Walters, because he knocked him out. So, you know, I think it'll be a very good fight with a just ending, however it ends. Not a fight you want to miss, I'm telling you. I don't care how upset you are at the Kovalev Ward debacle. You do not want to miss this fight. Loma's an extraordinary fighter. Once in boxing. A once, like I said, not a once in a lifetime fighter, man. A once in all of boxing's history fighter. Going up against Walters is his best opponent he's ever fought too. So you're seeing Lomachenko go up against the best opponent he has ever fought, and vice versa. Seeing both of these guys in the ring with the best guy either one has ever stepped in the ring with. In the pros. You know. But, yeah, let me know what you think about my breakdown and who my pick. I got Loma by decision. But like I said, I wouldn't be surprised if he stopped Walters late. Let me know what your pick is, and, KO, decision, and if you feel like typing it out, I'll read it and reply, a brief little breakdown of how you see the fight happening. You know, I like reading those, so, you know, if you got the time or desire, leave a little brief breakdown. All right, but give me your thoughts, man. Thunderdome Boxing Talk. Peace.